He knows the secrets of the heart. You cannot lie or hide truth from him. It's impossible. He knows, sees, hears everything you do and say. He's everywhere spiritually for his eternal judgment day and where you will end between life and death. Psalm 44:2. He knows the secrets of the heart. Psalm 50. The mighty one God, the Lord, speaks and summons the earth from Zion, Mount Zion, his holy city, where us righteous will live, perfect in beauty. God shines forth, our God comes, and will not be silent. A fire devours before him, and around him a tempest rages. He summons the heavens above and the earth that he may judge his people. Gather to me, my consecrated ones, who made a covenant, a binding contract with me, by sacrifice. And the heavens proclaim his righteousness, for God himself is judge. Hear, O my people, and I will speak, O Israel, where we will meet him. And I will testify against you, I am God, your God, for the world is mine and all that is in it. Call upon me, and I will deliver you, and you will honor me. But to the wicked, God says, what right have you to recite my laws as in Exodus 20, or take my covenant on your lips? You hate my instruction and cast my words behind you. You throw in your lot with the doctors, sexual moral, which is against one of the Ten Commandments in Exodus 20. You use your mouth for evil and harness your tongue to deceit. Consider this, you forget God, your creator and provider, or I will tear you to pieces with none to rescue. He who sacrifices thank offerings, praise and gives thanks, and their sins him completely, honors me and prepares the way, so that I will show him the salvation of God. Amen. Jesus here as you go through life. So open your ears and eyes, listen and hear the real God's truth. Amen, amen. Okay, now, about that time of year, start putting up your summer clothes and get out your fall clothes. I had a fall dress on this morning. I said, no, it's going to get in the 70s, so I don't think so. Anyway, it's about that time. We've been getting a lot of rain, I know, but we should be thankful. Look at California. They're having a severe drought, and they have nothing but massive fires there, so we should be thankful there. Look at the positive side, not the negative side. Amen, amen. Including as you go through life here. You're alive to see another day. Amen. Okay, now, I've been rehearsing and practicing my son's wedding this next month. They'll be performing and singing. And excuse me on the song, I didn't have any time on it. I won't be able to sing and preach on the riverfront until October 2nd. Because it's winded out. Okay, now. This week's sermon is called, He Knows the Secrets of the Heart. You cannot lie or hide to or from God or Heavenly Father. It's impossible. He knows, sees, hears everything you do and say. He's everywhere spiritually. For He has eternal judgment down where you end between life and death. And He's always here for us. Just lean on and put your trust in and on Him. Amen, amen. He knows the secrets of the heart, as in Psalm 44:21, Psalm 50. The mighty one God, the mighty one God, the Lord speaks and summons the earth from Zion, Mount Zion, on His holy city, where us righteous will live at the end. Perfect in beauty, God shines forth. Our God comes and will not be silent.
I see.
Fire devours before Him, and around Him a tempest rages. He summons the heavens above and the earth that He may judge. He's going to judge His people. He's going to judge His people. Gather to me, my consecrated ones, who made a covenant, binding contract with me, made by sacrifice. And the heavens proclaim His righteousness, for God Himself is judge. Remember this. Hear, O my people. I will speak. O Israel, well, we will meet Him. And I will testify against you. I am God. I am God, your God. For the world is mine, and all that is in it. Call upon me and I will deliver you. You will honor me, but to the wicked, God says. What right have you to recite my laws as in Exodus 20, or take my covenants on your lips? You hate my instruction and cast my words behind you. You throw in your lot with adulterers, the sexual moral, which is against one of His Ten Commandments in Exodus 20. You use your mouth for evil and harness your tongue to deceit. Consider this, you forget God, your creator and provider. Where I will tear you to pieces, with none to rescue, none's going to rescue you. He who sacrifices thank offerings and praise, gives thanks and their sins to Him completely, honors me, and He prepares the way, so that I may show the salvation of God, amen, so remember this, excuse me, okay, now let's pray. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be Thy name, Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Now, this week's children's lesson is life, L-I-F-E. Now, when we think of life, who or what comes to mind? I'm teaching you, in the beginning, God, our Heavenly Father, created the heaven and the earth. He gave us our first breath of life. Amen, amen. He breathed in the first man's nostril. Gave his first life. And he provides life for us. Therefore, we are to live our lives for and through him. Live it as he is the breath of life, the breath of life. Without him, there'd be no existence, including us, or eternal life with him. He is our purpose, our reason of why we are here, Therefore, we are to love God, our Heavenly Father, first, as our real true God and purpose and reason as we go through life here. And do the right things. Ask yourself, what WWJD, what would Jesus do before doing them? And share his love as in brotherly love. But we do not have to be friends with the ones who hurt us, especially when they keep doing them. As adults, we confront them. We confront them on the matter. But if they keep doing them, we stay away from them and keep sharing our love of God as in brotherly, love with others, ones who are our true friends. So we will inherit eternal life with God, our Heavenly Father. He is our one true friend. He is our one true friend. Trust in God. He's always here for us, and he does answer our prayers. Sometimes it takes a while, and as long as it's sensible, not for selfish and greedy reasons, but for such as forgiveness of those who hurt us, and give thanks for what, pray and give thanks for what we do have, not what we want and desire. We must look around and appreciate what we do have, and that God himself. Amen, amen. Now I've been teaching 2 Peter, for man's a slave to whatever has mastered you, you are a slave to. And God's chosen, anointed, appointed apostles, prophets, high priests, servants. Christ is coming again at the end of time. God's kingdom, Mount Zion, where us righteous will live with him in his holy city and his discipling. And in James 2, that faith and good deeds and actions work together, and your faith is made complete by what you do, To those by persistence in doing good, see glory, honor, and immortality. He, God, our Heavenly Father, will give eternal life with him in his kingdom. And be careful by and from depravity, scoffers, delusions, mockers, jackals, mutual haters of the flesh, and people who are ignorant and do other scriptures besides the Holy Bible to their own destruction, which is hell. Okay, now I've told you this, but this is for the newcomers. I should be dead 3 times. Twice I had cancer, once I had near-death experience. The last time I had cancer, I got down on my hands and knees. I just cried, fasted, and meditated for days. For days, I submitted myself, gave him, God, myself completely. Then my tumors disappeared. And I made him a promise. I have a binding contract with him now to tell the real God's truth. And when I had a near-death experience, I've seen both heaven, Jesus, and hell, the devil. So there really are both places. So who or what you use here as your God, is where you end, between life with God, our Heavenly Father, or hell, death, with the devil himself, burning eternally. So are your own wants and desires that you are darkened, enslaved, and mastered by really worth to end in hell? Really? No one or thing is worth to end in hell for burning eternally. No. Amen, amen. So remember this. Bless our Father, be being faithful with our Heavenly Father. Put him first in our life. Amen, amen. WWJD, what would Jesus do before doing them?
WCIC's call to worship. Anonymous friends dedicated to
Deuteronomy 11. 11, obey the Lord your God. Keep his requirements, his decrees, his laws, and ways. Amen, amen.
You reign.
And next is 20. It's 10 commandments. You sold your people for a
pittance, gaining nothing from their sow. You have made us reproach to our neighbors. The scorn and derision of those around us. You have made us but wayward among the nations. The people shake their heads at us. My disgrace before me all day long, and my face is covered with shame at the times of those who reproach and revile me. Because of the enemy who has bent on revenge. All this happened to us, though we had not forgotten you or been false to your covenant. Our hearts had not turned back. Our feet had not strayed from
your path.
But you crushed us and made us a haunt for jackals and covered us from with deep darkness. If we had forgotten the name of our God or spread out our hands to a foreign God, which is another God, would not God have discovered it? Since he knows the secret of the heart. Remember this. Yet for your sake, we face death all day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. Awake, O Lord. Why do you sleep? Rouse yourself. Do not reject us forever. Why do you hide your face and forget our misery and oppression? We are brought down to the dust. Our bodies cling to the ground. Rise up and help us. Redeem us because of your unfailing love. Amen, amen. So remember this. In Psalm 46, remember this. God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Remember that. He's always here for us. Just because we can't see him doesn't mean he doesn't exist. You can't see your hair, but air's everywhere to keep us alive. Amen, amen. God's at work spiritually. He's always here for us. Just lean up, just trust in on him. Amen, amen. Okay, go to Psalm 50. The mighty one God, the Lord, speaks and summons the earth. From the rising of the sun to the place where it sets. From Zion, Mount Zion, perfect in beauty. Amen, amen. God shines forth. Our God comes and will not be silent. A fire devours before him. And around him, a tempest rages. He summons the heavens above and the earth that he may judge his people. He's going to judge us. Gather to me, my consecrated ones, who made a covenant of mine contract with me by sacrifice. And the heavens proclaim his righteousness, for God himself is judge, judge. Remember this, he's going to judge us at the end, between heaven, life, or hell, death at the end. Oh, you know what I mean. It's Holy City at the end. The second coming of Christ Jesus. It's Holy City in Mount Zion, where this righteous will live, or death, hell. Find from whom what you truly listen and follow is your God. Amen, amen. Hear, O my people, and I will speak. O Israel, where we will meet him. And I will testify against you. I am God. Thank you for your sacrifices, or your burnt offerings, which are ever before me. Now we pray and give our sins to the cross and give him love to die. Leave him there. Bless our Father and be faithful to him. I have no need for a bowl for your staff or of ghosts from your pen. For every animal of the forest is mine, and the cattle on 1,000 hills. I know every bird in the mountains and the creatures of the field. over the world. The world is mine and all that is in it. Do I eat the flesh of bulls or drink the blood of goats? Sacrifice thank offerings to God. Like I said, now we pray since Jesus Christ died and suffered on the cross for us and our sins. Give our sins to his cross and let him die and leave them there. Fulfill your vows to the Most High. Fulfill your vows to the Most High. And call upon me in the day of trouble. In the day of trouble, I will deliver you and you will honor me. Honor me. But the wicked God says, what right have you to recite my laws in Exodus 20? Or take my covenant on your lips? You heed my instruction and cast my words behind you. When you see a thief, you join with him. You throw your lot with adulterers, the sexual moral. You use your mouth for evil and harness your tongue to deceit. You speak continually against your brother, which is anyone, and slander your own mother's son. These things you have done, and I kept silent. You thought I was altogether like you. But I will rebuke you, and accuse you to your face. Consider this. You who forget God. Or I will tear you to pieces, with none to rescue. He who sacrifices sink offerings honors me. And he prepares that way, so that I may show him the salvation of God. Amen. Wow, it's quiet out here today. Really nice out. Just got a couple bugs biting me, though. Okay.
Big Daddy Weave, part of Call to Worship, WCIC. Call a fast? Is it acceptable to the Lord? Is it not
this the kind of fasting I have chosen, to loose the chains of injustice, the chains of injustice, and untie the cords of the yoke, to set the oppressed free, and to break every yoke. It is not to share your food with the hungry, and to provide the poor wanderers with shelter. When you see a naked man, when you see the naked, to clothe him, and not to turn away from your own flesh and blood. When your light will break, a piece of hair in my eye, then your light, L-I-G-H-T, will break forth like the dawn, and your healing will quickly appear. When your righteousness will go before you, and the glory of the Lord will be your rear guard, then you will call, and the Lord will answer, and you will cry for help, cry for help, and he will say, here am I, If you do away with the yoke of oppression, with a pointing finger and malicious talk, and if you spend yourselves in behalf of the hungry and satisfy the needs of the oppressed, then your light, L-I-G-H-T, will rise in the darkness, and your night will become like the noonday. The Lord will guide you always. Amen. He's always guiding us. He will satisfy your knees in a sun-scorched land, and will strengthen your frame. You will be like a well-watered garden, like a spring whose waters never fail. Your people will rebuild the ancient ruins.
For me towards that,
and will rise up the old foundations. You will be called repair of broken walls. Restore our streets with dwellings. If you keep your feet from breaking a Sabbath, and from doing as you please on my holy day. If you call the Sabbath a delight and the Lord's holy day honorable. And if you honor it by not going your own way, and not doing as you please, or speaking idle words, then you will find your joy,
which is Bethany's discount,
which is Bethany's joy, in the Lord.
Yeah, you've got him.
And I will cause you to ride on the heights of the land, and to feast on the inheritance of your father Jacob. The mouth of the Lord has spoken.
Amen.
I can't even hear the radio hardly. Two baskets of figs. We haven't read this in a while. Jeremiah 24. Jeremiah was a true servant and prophet of God. Bite me. teacher from King Judah. And the fish is the craftsman and the artisans of Judah. We're carried into exile from Jerusalem to Babylon to, I can't pronounce it, excuse me. King of Babylon, the Lord showed me two baskets of figs placed in front of the temple of the Lord. One basket had very good figs. Like those that ripened early, the other basket had very poor figs, so bad, they could not be eaten. Then the Lord answered me, "What do you see, Jeremiah?" "Figs," I answered. "The good ones are very good, but the poor ones are so bad they cannot be eaten." Then the word of the Lord came to me. This is what the Lord, the God of Israel, says. Like these good figs, I regard as good the exiles from Judah, whom I sent away from this place to the land of Babylonians. My eyes will watch over them for they're good, and I will bring them back to this land. I will build them up and not tear them down. I will plant them and not uproot them. I will give them a heart to know me. Then I am the Lord. They will be my people, and I will be their God. For they will return to me with all their heart. But like the poor figs that are so bad you can't eat them, says the Lord. So I will deal with Zedekiah, king of Judah, his officials and the survivors from Jerusalem, whether they remain in this land or live in Egypt. I will make them abhorrent and an offense to all the kingdoms of the earth, a reproach and a byword, an object of ridicule and cursing, wherever I banish them. I will send a sword, famine, and plagues against them until they are destroyed from the land I gave them and the forefathers. Amen, amen.
We are your church. We need your power in us.
I need your power in us.
Build your kingdom
here. Let the darkness fear. Okay, excuse me. So my dividers are blown away. Oh, well, it's just a piece of paper. I orders condemned, Ezekiel 14, excuse me. Some of the elders of Israel came to me and sat down in front of me. Then the word of the Lord came to me, "Son of man, these men have set up idols in their hearts, and have put wicked stumbling blocks before their faces. Should I not let them inquire of me at all? Therefore speak to them and tell them this is what the sovereign Lord says. When any Israelite, which is anyone, sets up idols in his heart and puts a wicked stumbling block before his face, and then goes to a prophet, I, the Lord, will answer him myself in keeping with his great idolatry. I will do this to recapture the hearts of the people of Israel, who have all deserted me for their idols. Therefore, say to the house of Israel, this is what the sovereign Lord says. Repent, give your sins to the cross and let them die. Turn from your idols, and renounce all your detestable practices. When any Israelite, or which is anyone, or any alien living in Israel separates himself from me, and sets up idols in his heart, and puts a wicked stumbling block before his face, and then goes to a prophet to inquire me, I, the Lord, will answer him myself, and I will set my face against that man and make an example and a byword. I will kill them off from my people, and you will know that I am the Lord, I am the Lord.
AI Bloomington.
And if the prophet is enticed to utter a prophecy, I, the Lord, have enticed that prophet, and I will stretch out my hand against him and destroy him from among my people,
New Life Media.
Israel. They will bear the guilt. The prophet will be as guilty as the one who consults him. Then the people of Israel will no longer stray from me, nor will they defile themselves anymore. With all their sins, they will be my people, and I will be their God, their God, their God, declares the sovereign Lord. The word of the Lord came to me, son of man, the country sins against me. If a country sins against me, by being unfaithful, 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 and I stretch out my hand against it and cut it off and exclude supply and send famine upon it and kill its men and their animals. Even if these three men, we read this a few weeks ago, well, that's okay, God brought me back to it. Noah, Daniel, and Job, which are his faithful servants, were in it. They could save only themselves by their righteousness, 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 declares the Lord. Or if I send wild beasts through that country, and they leave it childless, and it becomes desolate, so that no one can pass through it because of the beast, as surely as I live, declares the sovereign Lord. And if these three men were in it, they could not save their own sons or daughters. They alone would be saved, but the land would be desolate. Or if I bring a sword against the country and say, let the sword pass throughout the land, and I will kill its men and their animals, as surely as I live, declares the sovereign Lord. Even if these three men were in it, they could not save their own sons and daughters. They alone would be saved. Or if I send a plague into the land and pour out my wrath, which is his anger in it, bloodshed, kill this man and their animals, as surely as I live, declares the sovereign Lord, even if Noah, Daniel, and Job, which are God's faithful servants, were in it, they could save neither son nor daughter. They would be saved themselves by their righteousness, righteousness, righteousness. For this is what the sovereign Lord says. How much worse will it be when I stand against Jerusalem by four dreadful judgments? Sword, famine, and wild beasts, and plague, to kill its man and their animals. Yet there will be some survivor sons and daughters who will be brought out of it. They will come to you, and when you see their conduct and their actions, you will be consoled regarding the disaster. I have brought upon Jerusalem every disaster. I have brought upon it. You will be consoled when you see their conduct and their actions, for you will know that I have done nothing in it without cause, declares the sovereign Lord. Amen, amen. Excuse me. My allergies. My nose is itching. Okay, excuse me. Remember, Jesus was even tempted by Satan, the devil. Jesus said to Satan, away from me, Satan. But it is written, worship the Lord your God and serve him only. Worship the Lord your God and serve him only. Amen, amen. If you worship and serve other gods, he knows. It's written in his book, and where will you end? Amen, amen. Between life with him or death. Amen. Okay, and remember this too. We haven't said this for a long time. Remember, people of the Bible were flogged, ridiculed, laughed at. Even Jesus Christ was crucified by and from their strong faith in God, our Heavenly Father. Amen, amen. Excuse me. First John 2:15. Do not love the world or anything or anyone in the world. You serve it as God. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father in heaven is not in him. For everything in the world, the cravings of sinful mind, the lust of his eyes, and the boast in what he has and does, comes not from the Father in heaven, but from the world. The world and its desires pass 2 Peter 3. The day of the Lord. Dear friends, this is now my second letter to you. I have written both of them as a reminder to stimulate you to wholesome thinking. I want you to recall the words spoken in the past by the holy prophets and the command given by our Lord and Savior through your apostles. First of all, you must understand that in the last days, scoffers will come, scoffing and following their own evil desires. They will say, "Where is this coming? He promised. Ever since our fathers died, everything goes on as it has since the beginning of creation. But they deliberately forgot that long ago by God's word, the heavens and the earth was formed out of water, by water. By these waters also the world of that time was deluged and destroyed. By the same word,
how do you put a price
the
on
present
version?
Heavens and earth are
in the dark time.
Reserved for fire,
and knowing you're not alone,
being kept for the day of judgment, and destruction of ungodly man, second coming Christ Jesus. Listen, over the years, this is God's truth.
You'll bring hope, encouragement, and
but do not forget this one
so
thing, dear
others.
Friends.
And that
with the Lord,
priceless.
A day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years is like a day. The Lord is not slow in keeping his promise.
Fundraiser begins October 4th. You can
as some understand slowness, he is patient with you, not wanting anyone to perish, which is die, but everyone to come and repent. Give your sins to this cross right now. Let them die, and leave them there. Love, serve, and be obedient to him. Amen. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief. The heavens will disappear with a roar. The elements will be destroyed by fire, and the earth and everything in it will be laid bare. Listen, the second coming of Christ Jesus. Amen, the end of time. Since everything will be destroyed in this way, what kind of people ought you be? You ought to live holy and godly lives. As you look forward in the day of God and speed its coming, that day will bring about the destruction of the heavens by fire, and the elements will melt in the heat. Amen. It's going to be fire. But in keeping with his promise, we are looking forward to a new heaven, a new earth. The home of righteousness, his holy city on Mount Zion, where us righteous will live. So then, dear friends, since you are looking forward to this, make every effort to be found spotless, blameless, and at peace with him. Bear in mind that our Lord's patience means salvation, just as our dear brother Paul also wrote you with the wisdom that God gave him. He writes the same way in his letters, speaking in these matters. His letters contain some things that are hard to understand, which ignorant and unstable people distort. As they do other scriptures besides the Holy Bible, to their own destruction, which is hell. Therefore, dear friends, since you already know this, be on your guard, so that you may not be carried away by the errors of lawless man, and fall from your secure position, but grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To him be glory both now and forever. Amen. Oh, I didn't forget anything. Like I said, a lot of my markers blew away, so excuse me if I did. Okay, I think I read the main one. I don't know. the way. So excuse me. Okay, number one, let's find peace, being faithful to God, Heavenly Father. Amen, amen. Number two, love and take care of your personal family. Your personal family. Your spouse and children. Number three, come to work 40 to 50 hours a week. And number four, come to two friends. Minimum purpose from organizations. Preach the gospel, the real God's truth. Number two, sell people. Number three, sell people. Our cities and state to make it a better, safer place to live. I've been with Governor Bruce Rauner on some issues, such as to enforce motorcycle helmets for safety, to shut down nuclear power plants and replace them with solar panels and wind turbines for our state safety. And Peoria's in East Peoria on some issues. On October 7th, I'll be having a fundraiser on the riverfront from about 2 to 6 p.m. Performers are welcome. But family friendly. And I'll have a box for ideas, etc. to present to Peoria. Again, like I've told you earlier, I won't be on the riverfront to preach and sing until October 2nd. There's something going on this coming weekend. I'm recording more songs on my computer's recording. I'm working on a natural body and face cream, excuse me. That'll work. I've written my fourth novel. On my first one, my oldest son needs to help me on something first. Then I'll send it to the Chicago's publisher and I'll go from there. My site, you can download some of my songs. I have more soon. My oldest son's getting married next month, so excuse me there. I have two professional video songs. Just go back on my sermons about 11 months ago. Just click on them and you can watch and hear them. And on my sermon, 180 at the beginning is another one. And for donations, if you donate, thank you, God bless you for it. I'm checking the government site for a grant to buy a building every day. I'm registered with them. So far, there isn't any. I passed out two of my flyers to truckers so they can watch my sermons on the Wi-Fi and told them to other truckers. And Jill Stein is in the Green Party. She's a doctor and is out to helping people. Amen, amen there. On my multifamily house, we are working on my back yard's patio and we'll paint the privacy gate this week. And working on the basement professionally so it'll look nice. My upstairs apartment's for rent. It's a small one bedroom with all utilities paid and internet. It's in a nice and safe neighborhood near bus stops, restaurants, gas station, and a trail walk. We walk, etc. every day. So my kids can catch a Pokemon. I'll be going to the gym more since I live closer. And when you see me there, I'm a musician. Write music, so excuse me there. I've written over 30 songs so far and searching the internet for a recording studio so I can make a record. They still call it records. My band's called The Last Seraph and Seraph is an Angel. I have WCIC plans with my family later.
For Steve Brown. I'm so
it's
glad
our personal family day.
Sure
we hang out together
Monday
and do family
morning,
things such as television. But
with the Tracy's
we mainly need to discuss
Jim
the wedding and my oldest son's birthday and make my homemade chow mein, which takes a few hours. Okay, now pray for a shooting in Philly. 5 people wounded for the families and victims. They found an airplane part, and it's been, confirmed, it's from the MH370 that went missing over 2 years ago. It was found off of Tasmania, I can't pronounce that, and Louisiana's flood from weeks ago for the victims, Florida and Hawaii's hurricane for the victims, Italy's earthquake from weeks ago for the victims, India's tornado from the victims. My mom, Gertrude, she has terminal cancer. Dan Margarita, Pastor Dice, D-I-C-E, they have health problems. John, Heather, Donald, and his 20 and 20-year-old daughters, they are going through something personal. David has severe asthma. Our president is caring hard work for our country. Presidency and voting, rulers of our state and cities, farmers, parents, grandparents, Medicare, bus drivers, schools, colleges, teachers, truckers, firemen and women, policemen and women, servicemen and women. I'm praying for you all. I'll pray for each other, for my health organization, songs, novels. Excuse me, I've written. Now may the love, peace, joy, and righteousness of bless you.